सो हाई एवरी वन, हाउ यू डूइंग ऑल? वेलकम टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल फिटनेस नट. एंड टूडे आई विल टीच यू सम ब्रीफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ सी प्रोग्रामिंग. लाइक आई हैव, इफ यू वॉच माई अर्लियर लेक्चर, आई हैव इंट्रोडक्टरी लेक्चर ऑफ सी प्रोग्रामिंग. आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन दैट लेक्चर दैट वाई आई एम टीचिंग दिस हिस्ट्री लेक्चर, वाई आई एम नॉट डिगिंग टू द कोड इटसेल्फ to make you I am doing it because to enhance your interest. I mean, if you know something about it, then your interest will automatically rise up, you know, you will be more keen to know about this. So I will be giving some brief introduction, the timeline of C programming, evolution of C programming, and what is the uses in present scenario. Okay, so let's hop into the presentation slide. So C was, you can say C was developed by initially by, Dennis Ritchie. One serious man. He is Dennis Ritchie. He was known as the founder of C programming. He has developed this C programming back in 1972. Actually, he didn't develop it, didn't develop the C programming at one go. He first developed other pre-programming language, then C, then dig into the C. Okay. So origin of C closely, you can read in the first line here, which I am provided here, that you can see that C was originally developed to be used in Unix operating system. You are using Windows in your PC or Android in your mobile, but the operating system, there are many other operating system. Unix is one of them. Okay, so think about this, it's like a operating system just like window, but it less graphic and more command, NIBA. Today's also more command, Unix have more command than Windows. Excuse me, means Unix is usually based on command prompt, usually cell, cron cell, bron cell, which is beyond this scope of this book. Okay, so let me just focus on the C part here. So the Unix operating system, firstly, it was C was developed. You can say there is link or connection between the development of C and evolution of Unix operating system. Okay. So Dennis Ritchie and Kim Thumser start working on this Unix operating system and wanted to do more, user friendly way coding. Like this, not the tedious job of writing long command here on C cell or bron cell. But to do more effective way, he developed C. So Kane Thomason designed a programming language. He designed a programming language to make utilities for the new platform. Means now Unix at that time at the development state, there were many more developing things coming in this Unix operating system at that time. So what he did, this Thomason guy, he just recently developed the BCPL programming language and B programming language. Okay, this programming language less wordy than earlier Kabul or Basic programming language. Okay, that word used long before. Kabul and Basic was just similar to, we can say, assembly language. These were not purely high level language. Okay, in this way you can understand it. In naive terminology, I just putting all my points. Okay, listen very carefully each and every point. You will definitely find it interesting, the history of C. You must know about each and every point. That's why I'm telling in more detail here. You can see that most of you find that why I am telling this all history, in more detail. Just I am to make you more interesting and more interested in the subject. Okay, that's my purpose. Nothing else. So, in 1972, Dennis Ritchie started to improve the B language. Okay, he does modification of B language, and what the result is C language. Okay, so these two guys are Dennis Ritchie and Thomson, Ken Thomson, and this is the book he had written in 1978. Or more earlier, 73, I don't know, I don't remember the date. So I am following in the entire course, this book, you can follow this course, you can follow this book, sorry, excuse me, follow this book, and you can download this PDF from online, or you can purchase this book. Very, you know, thin book of about 200 pages, but very interesting way. You know, there are a lot of books available in the market, but you know, the when a person develop a language and he has written about in his experience in this book, so it worth to follow in this book. Okay, you getting what I'm saying? Okay, so preprocessor. So what is preprocessor? Don't get the jargons, don't take jargons too, you know, seriously. Just I am naive way I am telling you. For example, like when you write, you know, for example, that you have so much music, want to keep the music in your computer, as copy this music in a computer. But when this music becomes so much, vast, many music, like then you start to devise the music as according to artist or the best songs or anything else. So preprocessing is like that. When they started, Dennis Ritchie started coding in C, the code itself become too large. So he, and there was so much, you know, same part of code, some bunch of code are repeating in every code he started to write. So what he does is just combine all the file which are being used in every program or every code. For example, that every code, some code, you most of the code you take input from the user and provide output to the user, and these were command used in all the files. So and writing all the files is so, you know, not become ambiguous, you can say. So he created this preprocessor directly in 1973. Okay, same concept was used in BCPL. Give more term, like include or define, just more less macros. I don't dig into the jargons I am using. Okay, some of might be confusing for you, so just go with a flow and keep patience. You will definitely learn at the end of the course what were these. You know, if you come this to lecture to back and want to revise this course, then you will, oh, the preprocessor one that like that, and last time I didn't get it, but this time I'd get it. Okay, like that. So just go through the flow. So don't take all the jargon seriously. Okay, so around 1977, Ritchie and Stephen C. Johnson made further change. Another colleagues of Dennis Ritchie joined him at Bell Laboratory. They think that at the time the Windows micro operating system was also in so much trend. People are using Windows rather than Unix. So they think that let me just port this C language to work in Windows too. That's why they developed portable C compiler. What's it's written? Okay. Now in 1978, which I have told you that I forgot the date. So in 1978, Brian Kingston and Dennis Ritchie, Kringken and Dennis Ritchie published the first edition of the C programming language. Okay. Which you can see here. This book known to C programmer as KNR. Why KNR? Because Dennis Ritchie rich for K for King Kringken and R for Ritchie. It serves as many years as an informal specification of the language. Means informal specification means what? And I understand that it's just like a user manual. You know, like you purchase something, and the marketer provide you the user manual card or someone to how to use the product. In the same way, they used it as a user manual to, you know, modify it or write their code on C, and not only themselves but all the colleagues of the Bell Laboratories, as well as the student who were fascinated about this programming language. Okay, the version of C that they describe commonly referred to as CNRC. Okay, so 1978 version is also known as KNRC. Okay, referring to this book. As this was released in 1978, it is also known as C78. So I will tell you that there are different version of C. C70 was the first version of C. You can imagine, like the version software have version, na? In a similar manner, C have version, like C78. Okay. So, now coming to 80s, C gradually, now many people are using this C because they made changes like portable, make it portable so that it can be now used in Windows, and most of the people at that time following the Windows operating system. So it gradually rises popularity. Means, oh, he's using C, let me use C. It's very interesting language, very much high language. Okay, like that. Very advanced high language, pardon me. It has become one of the most widely used programming language. Okay, most widely used programming language, like I said. So in 1983, ANSI was formed. You know, I will be using lot of these jargons of ANSI in C programming. ANSI, you know, just in naive way, think that it give standardization of C. Means like in chemistry, IUPAC name give the standardization to, you know, nomenclature of the compound in C chemistry. In a similar way, ANSI provide the standardization of C. Okay. The C standard was, you know, further revised, you know, 3 to 4 times. Like 1990s, it was named as C99. You know, it was, you know, whenever more features are added, new version are created. Okay. In 2007, work began on another side, another revision of C standard, informally called C1X. Until the its official publication means the 2007 modification where it start to doing modification were going on until the year 2011 and 2012. There was some modification were going on. See, it was better version of this new softwares, new, or you can say new compiler, C1X. It is known as C1X. Okay. So moving on. So now committee was formed, standard committee. It means they will, it means some modification will come, they will just modify it. Means give the approval or deny it, some like, you know, committee type. Okay. Now 2018, C17 was formed. Okay, which does some modification in C11. C2 is informal name of next C17. Means now the beta version of C17 were developed, which is now called as C2X, which will officially become C21 in this year of December 2021. Okay. So now what I have told you, I am just providing you a table here, which will give you the timeline and the modification and the committee involved in this modification. Okay. So here we go. So firstly, AGUL was developed in 1960 by international group. Then BCPL was developed in 1961, as I told in the first slides. And then B was developed. Then traditional C was developed by Dennis Ritchie in 1972. Okay. Then KNR, after the publication of the books in 1978, they called it a CNR version, also known as C78. Okay. Now, in the 1989, as I told you, ANSI was formed. Then ANSI IOSA standard was formed in 1990. Then in 1999, C99 was formed by standardization community. Then C11 in 2011 and C17 in 2017. And now C2X version is going on, beta version, which will be come into official version in this year of December. Okay. So that was some history of C. Oh, lastly you have completed it. Yay. Take rest some, pause the video and take some rest. No, because I am changing this topic to now the practical uses of C. Okay. So hope you find it interesting, that history of C, that why it is being used, why the modification, development of C, evolution of C, and now what is the present thing going on, like C2X version is in beta in beta version, which will be coming to official in this year. Okay, so before going into the use of C, let me tell you something about the language. So you might have heard C language, Python language, Java language, Ruby language, C hash language, C sharp language, many more. Okay, so what are these language? You know, like we are human beings, what we, how we communicate, how we, let suppose that we want to get something from anyone, and suppose we want to let the person work something for you, for that what if we do, we command that person, or no, if there is inferior remaining, your superior, to command an employee to do this. In similar way, we command the computer to do these things, which is defined in language for computer science. Okay, computer language, which is popularly known as now programming language. Okay, so programming language dated back earlier, you know, you in your school day, you might have, you know, read about what I can say, the language of C, languages of, you know, computer, sorry, pardon me, excuse me, language of computer. So there were only three languages. Firstly was machine language, then assembly language come, then most of the thing are going on, you know, high level language. So what is machine language? Suppose we have, you know, human beings followed a 10 base system. Base 10 system means you have 10 fingers, like we grip instruction of numericals in 0 to 9 range. In similar way, computer follow binary system, which give the output, which give take input as 0 as 1. So earlier days, back in the days of 1940, after the World War II, the computer was taking boom and lot of, you know, advancement in the society or in the market. So earlier, what normal person cannot use computer. Why? Because, you know, because it only understand binary coding, and most of the person, it will be very difficult to give a copy command to you know, computer to do the work. You have to write lot more you know, extension of binary code, like 0111110111111, like something like that. So to reduce this, so it was very tedious for, you know, naive user or normal user who just wanted for fun, anything fun from the computer to use it. So then come to assembly language. So assembly language just some reduction of some, you know, codes of commands of, you know, in binary system, which are given as a machine code. And that assembly language are also not so, you can say, not so tedious, but it's still tedious, because you have to write something, like for example, add two number. You have to give the instruction that add 1 plus 2, or add the location value of 1 and the location value of 2. So it was also very tedious to run one instruction. We have to give lot of commands, you know, line by line commands. If you have used assembly language, you know what I'm talking about. Okay. After assembly language, high level language was come, you know, to reduce, to make it user friendly, and just go from the tedious job. So now everything, most of the thing in the world, and most of the thing in the computer is done by high level language. Means human are now more likely to give command in easier way to computer. Okay, you can understand it. And in the future, in fifth gen of computer, you from whatever I telling you is, it is from school days computer science course. Okay, nothing more I am telling you. So in what fifth gen will do, in fifth gen computer, the computer will completely replace by AI. You know, for example, if you want to add two number, just instruct the C programmer here that add 2 plus 3. It will directly listen to your command and add the number. Okay, so I think it is very interesting. No, so now take a rest some time, pause the video if you want, and then let hop into the uses of C in practical world. Okay. So like I told in last lecture, if you have listened the last lecture, if you have watched the last lecture, excuse me, but I have told there that why I am not using Python here, why I am teaching C, because you can raise the question that C is most, Python is most widely used in industry. Yeah, you are right, but it's not my motive to teach you industry based. My motive to teach you complete scope of programming, means complete depth knowledge of programming, and which is only and one and only can be given by C. Okay, so C was basically used as system programming language for most of the operating system, like Android, like you are using Android in your cell phones. So in the Android operating system, there is in the base of operating system, there is kernel, which provide interface between you and the phone. which is on kernel topic of kernel beyond the scope of the topic, beyond the scope of this topic. I will, if I made some course on operating system, then I will dig into the details of kernels. Okay, so for just now, understand that all the operating system, core operating system like Android or Linux or Sun Solaris or Unix or Windows, etc., all are core language of it is C. Okay, just understand it in a naive way. So this is a graph which is showing here in your skin. Some of the language might be invisible because of the skin, because of my video. It's video skin in the rightmost corner. So don't worry about it. You can Google it out in everywhere. You can find it. I just taken a official data of Taibo programming community. Taibo is a, you know, is community type which rank rate gives rating to programming language. Like, you know, IMDb giving rating to movies or series. In a similar way, Taibo gives the rating of programming language. Okay, so you can see the graph here. So you can see the graph here. This is just moving downward, upward. Means in the black is for Java. Java was very popular rating in 2002. You can see there, and it drastically dropped in 2004 to 2006. You can see here, and see, in on the other hand, were not so popular at that time, but it was growing in 2006. Okay, you can see this graph. Still Java popular till 2008, 2010. Here we can see. Let me show you this. Okay, this graph is, you know, from this is going downward, and here it is combined with this graph. Okay, so you can see this, that as time progresses in the latest world, C is most widely used language. Okay, this is for C. So C is most widely used language. Okay, get it? You can see all other graph here also. You can Google it out anywhere, you will find it. Okay. So next lecture. So let me go into the next slide. Let me open it. So you can see here, this graph is very important. As air passes, you know, the growth of C as is passing by. Okay, now moving on. So C can be used in website programming, you know, like CGI effect in movies. You might have seen that CGI effect of movies. That at that time, CGI effect, someone use this, use C for C language using CGI effect. Okay, just understand it. Common gateway interface. Okay. So, like I told you, that CGI uses the C programming language. Okay, and some of the web like website you are using, some web server coding, the server coding, and to, you know, launch the page website to show it in your browser, all the things are mostly done by C programming. Okay, all the thing need coding na. It's not like automated system that you have intelligent, you can do it. So you have to code na. So okay, moving on. So this, because of this, C is widely used programming language, and most of the, you know, I showed you libraries of many different language, modern language like Python, Perl and PHP are written in C. Okay, so C enables programming to create a efficient implementation of algorithm data structure. Oh yeah, it is the most important point. You know, most of the algorithm data structure is really very difficult if you are using it, and if you are keen interest to learn algorithm data structure, it will be very difficult to learn in Python or any modern programming language, because in modern programming language, most of the things are encapsulated. Encapsulated means all the things which are going on, which we can do in C, are going on the background in this programming language. So that's why it's very easier, very effective way to discuss algorithm data structure in C programming. In fact, if I'm gonna teach the algorithm and data structure in this course, in my course, I will definitely choose C language. Okay. So like MATLAB, mechanical student have used MATLAB, which are also partially written in C. So it's sometimes C serve an immediate language in like Python and your computer. So intermediate language is C between them. Means you are interactive with your computer via Python, but C is the intermediate language. Okay. So C has both directly and indirectly influenced many letters such Java, C script, you can see C sharp and everything. So that's all for all. So thank you.